many children, back to school is just a few weeks away. The transition from a lazy summer to a strict school schedule, it's tough for the whole family. And joining us today with some helpful advice is UAB psychologist Dr. Josh Klapo. Dr. Josh, help us out here. It really is a whole family transition.
Oh, yes. And I'm talking about it now. People are saying to me, you know, you're going to come in and you're ruining everybody's summer.
Come on, let us have our summer.
I want you to have your summer, but I'm looking towards that first day of school, and I want to make sure that first day is not complete chaos.
Okay.
And that's why we're starting really early, really gradually, so by the time the first day of school comes, your kids won't know what happened.
All right, so tell us what to do.
We're going to work on physiology first, and what I mean by that is sleep. Mm. So you have a lot of kids staying up 10, 11, 12, or later.
Oh, yeah.
And they're waking up at 9, 10, 11, 12, or later. You cannot switch sleep cycle the night before. Start now, start this week, maybe 10 or 15 minutes going to bed earlier, but you also have to wake them up 10 to 15 minutes mm-hmm. earlier. That's the hard part. Mm-hmm. But if you do that now, then by the time we get to the school year, then their body is going to be much more used to the sleep cycle.
Okay, so get the sleep going the right way. What else?
Second, brains have to start getting focused academically. Now, some kids, they study all year, and that's great. But a lot of kids don't, and a lot of parents will start making them read for, you know, an hour and a half a day. 10 to 15 minutes, that's it. It's almost symbolic. What you're trying to do is get that brain focused on focusing on something academic. So by the time the school year starts, they will have had that 10 to 15 minutes every day underneath their belt.
Okay, and make it gradual, so you don't want them to start hating this idea of school.
Exactly, and that gets to the third part, which is the environment. There's gonna be a meet the teacher night, there's gonna be an orientation, get your books, get your materials. Don't rush through that, because a lot of parents are like, come on, get your classes, let's go, 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 go. That's the part that really seals the deal for the child and makes it positive. So if you stay positive about that, then they have a better experience. The last part, which is hard for a lot of us parents, is stay calm, stay positive, because your child's gonna whine, they're gonna complain. If you stay positive, then what they learn is that this is a good experience. No matter what I feel, it's gonna be positive. We do that now, and by the time the school year starts, it's routine and it's much easier.
Yeah, and back to school, it can be fun. I mean, a lot of kids look forward to it. All that shopping, all that
Absolutely.
Stuff's good. All right, thanks, Dr. Josh. Sarah.